Today we'll go over the difference between the bisecting technique and the paralleling technique in dental imaging. This is specifically for Rio Salado CDA 240 class, but the concepts can be applied in any other dental imaging class. So here we could approach this a couple of ways. Maybe the easiest, most systematic way is to think about the fact that we have the paralleling technique and the bisecting technique. So in this assignment, you're asked to identify the image which would be an accurate bisecting technique, an accurate paralleling technique, and then which ones would be elongated or foreshortened in either a foreshortened bisecting technique or a foreshortened paralleling technique, and same for elongating, elongated paralleling or elongated bisecting. So to start off with, let's look at this image here. So imagine these are the upper teeth, this is the occlusal plane, lower teeth, and we're working on the molar, on the upper molars. So what you should think of is the paralleling technique. The long axis of the tooth this way should be parallel with the image receptor, which is, could be a film, a phosphor plate, or a wired or wireless sensor. And so let's draw the image receptor here. Let's say call it a film for conventional reasons. So this would now be parallel with the tooth. And usually if in the paralleling technique, you use an XCP or some to make the film stable and parallel. So let's see, the bite block would be something like this. It'd be just the back support would be supporting the film. So you have one part of the film touching the hard palate and one part of the film supported in the bite block this way. So now you want the X-ray beam to come at 90 degrees to the long axis of the tooth, and in this case they're parallel to the film, and the long axis of the tooth are parallel long axis of the film. So this is the X-ray beam. The X-rays converge when they come out. And so let's draw the central beam, come this way, and then you want to be at 90 degrees. 90 degrees equals good image. For the bisecting technique now, the major difference is that the image receptor is no longer parallel with the long axis of the tooth. So let's identify the long axis of the tooth. It's simply the longest symmetrical plane of the tooth. And then this way, and now the film will probably be in some kind of hemostat or a snap array holder. When you put the film in, one part would touch the palate, come up against it, and then the other part would have no support like this, no bite block, so it would probably just touch wherever it can, which would mean usually right next to the tooth here. So now this is the film, X-ray film. So now if you continue this axis, long axis of the tooth, long axis of the film, they are no longer parallel. What you want to do is bisect this difference in angles, after which this technique is called. So you just bisect or divide in half these angles. It's just kind of an imaginary line, and you get used to it with practice. And on paper, this is how you do it. And when you do it on the patient, you don't really think about drawing the line. You kind of approximate it, obviously. And let's see. So now you want to be perpendicular or 90 degrees to the bisector line rather than the film. So we want to be coming at this way. So the PID X-ray beam would be coming out this way, diverging. All right, casting shadow on the film of the tooth, and then this is the X-ray beam, and we have it 90 degrees to the bisector line. Now the other options is you could have an elongated image or a foreshortened image. An elongated image would have more than 90 degrees angle. So for the bisecting technique, you would have, it would be, say this is still the bisecting technique, and the PID would be maybe right here, and it would now form this angle, which is more than 90 degrees. And if you were to do less than 90 degrees, you'd get a foreshortened image, and it would look something like this. So you would come up really much steeper. All right, and then to the bisector line. So now you have this angle, which is less than 90 degrees. So you have a foreshortened image. Same thing for the paralleling, except now you would be aligning thinking about the long axis of the film. All right.